Hey amigos, what's happening? Back at you with another video. In the last video you saw, I was getting that thing running. And I said that it seems to be acting like it's not running right with that carburetor that I stuck on there. I had some alignment issues and, well, anyway, go watch that video and see what I'm talking about. That video is right there. So anyway, what I'm going to do, I'm going to pull this carburetor out of this bike and see what I can do with this plethora of carburetor stuff that I have laying around this table. The piece that I said I was looking for, that I was waiting to come in the mail, is this piece right here. Because the body I want to use is, where's it at? It's down here somewhere. Ah, here it is. This is the body that I want to use. Because, I don't know if you can notice, but this surface right here, where the bowl meets, well, you see how it's shaped? We're right there. Okay. I was trying to use a bowl that was shaped like this. See how different that little curve is? So what happened is that they didn't meet right and it was leaking gas, and that's why I used a different carburetor. But I want to use this body because it's got the matching surface, as you can see. So I'm going to pull that carburetor out and I'm going to take all the innards out of it and stick it in this body and see if everything runs a lot better. Okay, so without any further ado, I'm just going to put you on a tripod and, well, shoot, I shouldn't give away my filming secrets. Tripod, I shouldn't have said that. Oh well, not like it's a big mystery anyway. So let's see what we can accomplish. Okay, some of you who may have dealt with CV carburetors before may have experienced when you go to remove the fuel line off of them, these little plastic spigots will tend to break off. So a good fix for that, if they ever do break or if you ever want to replace them, is to buy these little bronze things. It's a 90 degree spigot and it just presses right in here. And if you ever want to reuse it, put it on another carburetor, pretty much just stick this in a vise like this and just kind of work it out. In the same way with installation, so as I'll demonstrate, like I'm about to show you. Get it in there like that and just get a good bite on it. Make sure you're not biting on any of the aluminum housing. I try to get mine nice and even and just tighten it down, and I just kind of work it back and forth like this and kind of pull up at the same time, and I feel it coming. I think I see it coming, and boom, there it is. It's out. And one other thing I like to do when I install these is that I like to put a little grease on the end to just kind of make the installation a lot smoother, and they tend to come out a lot easier because the grease doesn't really go anywhere. So where is that carburetor body? Oh, there it is. All right, it's only on the aluminum. So, and I just kind of squeeze it and it goes in with no argument. And boom, there it is. Okay, here's all the pieces, parts laying everywhere, and how to get all that stuff into this little body right here. This is the carburetor body that I used to install that intake manifold. So the other one didn't want to agree with the installation that this one made. So I really believe that's a lot of what my problem was with it idling too high. So let's see if I can get this together. Yeah, no, I can't. I need to just see if I can remember how to put them all together. Oh yeah, I almost forgot my fuel pump diaphragm. And I'm kind of hoping that this piece will match that surface right there. Like I said, this is a later model and I hope not much has changed, you know, between the pump diaphragm clamps, things, whatever. So let's see what happens. Okay, got it on there. Got a brand new intake seal on the carburetor. I tend to always want to replace those every time I do that, because especially in that scenario, because I think that last seal got a little beat up from having too much stress in one spot. I don't know, but anyway, I put a brand new one on there. That thing bolted up a whole lot better. I didn't have any alignment issues, so I have a feeling it's going to run a lot better. So let's take a look and see how it goes, if the battery ain't too dead by now, because the battery's kind of weak. Let's see. Okay, let's turn on the gas, and hopefully there's no gas leak, and if there is, then it's all back to the drawing board. So far I don't see any dripping. Okay, the enrichner in place. Let's see what happens. Here goes nothing. Well, that sounded like shoes in a dryer, didn't it? I really, really wanted to say that I'd improved things, but it didn't improve a single thing. But it did bolt on a lot better, like I said just a little bit ago. As you can see, I'm wearing a different shirt, so this is a couple days later, as I'm not satisfied with ending the video like I was going to end it, you know, and try and play off like everything was a lot better. But I will tell you what the deal is, believe it or not. I think I'm probably done with points and condensers, because that's the problem with this thing, why it was running kind of funny. I mean, I got it running. It ran great. Sort of ran great until I got warmed up. As you guys heard, that it sounded like it had an intake leak, but apparently EVOs were never meant to run with points. That little cutaway on the cam, you know, where you put your little cup thing for your electronic ignition, that changed in 1978, apparently. They changed it to another position when electronic ignition came out. So you can run points on an EVO. You can run them on early shovels and stuff. Maybe I'm talking out of turn, but you can run them on EVOs, but they won't run right. I mean, no matter where I had the points plate, I could rotate it all the way advanced or rotate it all the way retard, and no matter what, I would advance my cam, and when I'm trying to set my static timing, and it would open the points no matter where that plate was. That's why I say apparently they must have changed where that notch is on the cam when the electronic ignition came out, because it just wasn't happening when it came time to set my static timing. So I put the Dyna S ignition in there, you know, had it up on a rack. In fact, as you can see, it's still on the rack. But after putting that ignition in there and did the static timing thing, that thing fired up like a champ, sounded great. It was awesome. And then I killed it so I can set the carburetor. And then I went to start it again. Check it out. Nothing. So it turns out to be not the starter relay, because after my buddy Carson, who came over last night, after chasing wires and putting multimeters on things, power's going to the relay, power's coming from the switch to the relay, here's the wire that goes to my starter, and there's no power coming out when I hit the starter switch. But after taking the wire off the starter and then hit the starter switch, then there's power going through it. So apparently in my solenoid, something is a mess, because something must have gave out in here. I guess the saga is not done with the redemption bike. Maybe there's some bugs to be worked out on it. Actually, yeah, obviously there's some bugs to be worked out on it. So that's that, guys. So I hope you like what you've seen. I know the video was probably a little more entertaining than it was informative, but I don't know. That's just me. I like to make videos that I like to watch, not videos that bore the crap out of me. So maybe that's a little bit of the selfishness in me. But if you like what you're seeing, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, or at least if this is one of your first videos of mine that you're seeing, feel free to subscribe. It's all free. If you didn't like the video, hit that thumbs up anyway and subscribe and watch every one of them that come out. And also check out my links down below. I have a Patreon if you want to be part of the channel. You know, as far as supporting the channel, that does more than anything, because all I can do is just, well, that's enough about Patreon. The link's down below. You decide what you want to do with that. And as always, guys, you guys keep the rubber side down. Be good to yourselves, all right? Thanks a lot.